If any of you grew up in the 80s, then you know how difficult some of those old Nintendo games could be. I'm looking at you, Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles. We even have a trope now that's called Nintendo Hard. These games are experiencing a renaissance right now with games like Super Meat Boy and Dark Souls. Why am I talking about video games anyway? Well, first of all, I love them. But they can also help you overcome arguably one of the most difficult stumbling blocks an artist can have. And that's the fear of failure. Robot Unicorn Attack put it best. You will fail. It doesn't mean that you can't keep chasing your dreams. And the cool thing is, with every failure comes new experience and a new set of skills. You can apply this idea to music really simply. All you have to do is the exact opposite of what I said in the last video and just let your imagination run crazy. Take whatever pops into your head. Never tried a genre before? Head right in without any thought as to how you should go about that. Why not write 128th notes at 140 beats per minute? What do you got to lose? Maybe combine two or three keys and play them with different melodies simultaneously. Or if you want to get even weirder, try two completely different theory systems, like Western theory system and maybe take some of the Indian theory system and just smash them together, see what happens. Now go ahead and go write something. Take a day or two to forget about what you wrote about, and then go back and have a listen. Hopefully it's kind of terrible, but with some good ideas in it. If it's not, you have not taken it far enough. Just go back, write something even weirder. There's an entire music genre called noise. I bet you can't guess what the artists do for that one. Now, noise music may not be for me specifically, but if it weren't for people like John Cage and 4 minutes and 33 seconds or his radio music, then we may not even be using samples and some cool EDM today. Some of your music is going to fail to communicate what you're trying to convey. It's totally fine. It's going to happen. And the sooner you accept it, the better. You don't even need to put those nasty pieces where anybody else can hear them. Just keep these horrible little pieces of music to yourself and use them as stairs so that you can reach way in the back of your mind on the top shelf to pull out the best ideas. All those best ideas are way in the back underneath a whole bunch of stuff and probably with a lot of dust on them. I really hope that this helps now. Go be weird and have fun failing.